So it's a little late in October. I don't know when this is going to go up, but I did want to do an on-camera October fragrance tray video. I'm doing this on camera because I really don't have a dedicated fragrance tray for fragrance tray video. So until then, I'm on camera basically. But ideally, I want to do these off camera because I just feel like it's part of the perks of a fragrance tray video. It's not having to be on camera. But I just wanted to recap a little bit about my September fragrance tray. And I'm only going to talk about two fragrances from my September fragrance tray because they were the most long-lasting fragrances. Because I discovered that, say, for instance, the Ebony Wood fragrance from Zara, which was on my fragrance tray in September, didn't last nearly as long as I thought it would. So the longest lasting fragrances in my September tray were Mancera's Amore Cafe. This baby, this lasts for hours. It pretty much lasted all day. And the reason why I mention this, for me as still a fairly new fragrance loving person, fragrance content creation on my channel still pretty new. I enjoyed doing the September fragrance tray because the majority of it, or a good deal of it, was it September? It was September. Well, anyway, one of the fragrance trays I did, I had a lot of travel sizes. So travel sizes I can spray on when I feel like the scent is fading away. But if I'm putting full bottles of fragrance on my fragrance trays, as one will, I can't take these with me. I don't want to take full bottles with me. So I'm just saying, Amore Cafe, you don't gotta take this with you. You overspray this in the morning, you are good for the day. And the other fragrance, which I suspected had the same level of performance, lasted all day, didn't have to reapply. Commodity Milk. And I have this in the Bold Expression. I do also want to pick this up in Expressive. I like both expressions of Commodity Milk. This is one of my favorite fragrances ever. The first fragrance that I ever picked up in a full bottle in my collection. This lasts all day. Last all day, didn't have to think about reapplying. I did, however, I had a small sample that I'd gotten from Sephora Digital Events, but I used that up really quickly. Afterwards, when I wanted to wear this, I could spray it directly from the bottle and be good for the rest of the day. So the fragrances on my October fragrance trays are as follows, in no particular order. I will start with four travel sizes that I really kind of want to like either finish up or like get halfway down through. Some of them are already more than halfway done. So if you want to find out what my October fragrance tray fragrances are, keep watching. So the first travel size fragrance on my October fragrance tray is Vanilla Skin by Fleur. As you can see, it's pretty much done already. I don't know if you can see that little tiny bit that is left. It's kind of ridiculous how quickly I went through this. I love this fragrance. If you're a vanilla lover and never smell this, get your nose on it. It is just so good. It's so warm and addictive and cozy and sensual and all the good things. Definitely getting a full bottle of this. The second travel size fragrance is Nest's New York's Vanilla Bourbon fragrance. This didn't have a really great reception, I feel, in general, from fragrance content creators that I follow, but I like it. I love a vanilla bourbon note in most things. I don't quite know where I am with this. I think I still have a good bit left of it because the sticker goes all the way around, so I can't really tell. This is my second travel size though, because long story short, the first one I got to do a first impression of, I finished it without even knowing. I didn't even know where it was, and one day I sprayed it and it was gone. So I do enjoy this. Definitely want to wear this for October. So the third travel size fragrance that I want to wear in October is an old favorite, and this is probably my third or fourth purchase of this. This was a fragrance that I had first discovered when I first got into my fragrance era, and this is Woodforia by Boysmells. So this is what that looks like. I don't know if you, is this sharp? Is it focused? There we go. And this is a really unique, earthy, but sweet fragrance that just makes me think about like walking in the woods. It is truly well named as Woodforia. It's one of the fragrances that I smell for the first time and realize that I like earthy scents, that I like scents with like wood in it. So I think that this is a good fragrance to start to finish up. As you can see, it's already halfway done. Woodforia, my boy smell for October. The fourth travel size fragrance, I've talked about this, I believe, on my channel, is from Noise. This is a fragrance line from Jerome Epinette for Ulta. And this is the fragrance Unmute. And you can see that is down here right now. I really do enjoy this fragrance. It reminds, I think it's gotten better since I've gotten it. I've only had it maybe like a month or so, maybe 2 months. It is woody. It has a warmth to it. It kind of reminds me a little bit of Hinoki wood, if you've ever smelled that note before, the Hinoki fragrance, but it's sweeter. It's sweeter. And I really do enjoy this. It's a warm, cozy fragrance. I'm not sure whether I would repurchase this, but I have been enjoying it for what I get from it and what I've gotten from it, you know, as I've had it. So again, this is another fragrance that I think I can either finish up or at least just get most of the way down through this for October. So the full bottle fragrances going on my October fragrance tray. I have two from Zara. One that I recently did a dedicated video for, and this one is By Love, and this is from their Into the Wood line. I recently sprayed this fragrance just for myself, you know, just oversprayed it for myself. It lasts a long time, you guys. It lasts for hours. I don't remember the notes of this. I will put a link to my dedicated review of it. I just love this fragrance. I will say that it is mostly rose-centered. It is LMR rose, patchouli, and sandalwood. I think those are the notes. It is a beautiful freaking fragrance. It's sandalwood, patchouli, and rose. So I was right on that. And it's just gorgeous. And it lasts for hours. So good. So feminine, you know, sensual, but like, it's got woody tinges. I like to say that it's softly tinged with woodiness on the edges. The LMR rose is just elegant and elevated. And I'm just a huge, huge fan of this fragrance. So this is the first full bottle fragrance that is going on my October fragrance tray. The second full bottle fragrance is also from Zara. It is Eternal Devotion. I did a dedicated review of this as well. This, I know for sure, is in collaboration with Jerome Epinette because I'm familiar with the other fragrances in this line. This is what Eternal Devotion looks like. This also has three notes in it. Blackcurrant, rose, turkey, it says on the front, and ambroxan. I mean, I get the black currant right off the top and the rose next. The ambroxan, I guess, gives it some depth and woodiness. It's a fantastic fragrance. And I haven't really been wearing my rose fragrances out and about. So I'm hoping that as the temperature gets colder, it'll be a nicer kind of like environment to wear these, both of these rose fragrances from Zara that I absolutely love, Eternal Devotion and By Love. So a third full bottle fragrance is from Snif, and this is Heal the Way. This is a fragrance that I have been dying to try and finally picked up, I want to say a few weeks ago. I'm not sure if I've had it a month yet. I also did a dedicated review to this. This is what the packaging looks like. As much as I'm not a fan of Snif's packaging overall, I really like the way that this bottle was done. And this is a fragrance done in collaboration with Alex. I don't remember what her last name is. I should know these things. Let me look it up. So this fragrance was done in collaboration with Sniff, and I believe she was a content creator on YouTube. Her name is Alex L. This has Palo Santo, pistachio cream, some other notes. I remember these were the key notes, and I love this fragrance. It is so sweet, creamy, soothing. I'm not a fan of the burning Palo Santo, the wood itself, so I was nervous about smelling this, but it's not overwhelming in this fragrance. It blends really well with the other notes in this and with the pistachio cream, which I really like. This is one of the few pistachio fragrances to come out this year, I believe, that I actually really, really like, because I was not a fan and I have not been a fan of the Kayali pistachio fragrance. God knows I want to, but I just don't. It just didn't do it for me. So this one is a pistachio fragrance that I really, really, really like. So, and I haven't worn this one out yet, so I'm looking forward to wearing it for this month. So the last fragrance on my October fragrance tray is going to be Billie Eilish. Eilish is actually the name of the fragrance, and this is a 50 mil. So it's not like the large bottle, but it is a full bottle in my opinion. And this is what that looks like. And this is, in my opinion, I mean, this was the first fragrance that Billie Eilish put out. There are two more. There's Billie Eilish 2 and there's 3 as well. I think that this is just such a beautiful vanilla fragrance. It has mandarin and another kind of like dark berry off the top note. It's got cacao in this. It's got vanilla. I don't know if it's, I think it might be vanilla caviar. I don't know if it's vanilla absolute, but it's just such a good vanilla fragrance. Oh, I'm almost kind of scared to wear this because I'm just gonna go crazy with it because I don't feel like it has like really great longevity, but we'll see. I'm still putting it on my fragrance tray for this month. So that is pretty much it. Those are all the fragrances that I will be trying to wear this month. And I have some other fragrances coming in new that hopefully I won't cheat on my tray with, but I did cheat on my last tray a little bit with the, I cheated on my last tray with Vanilla Skin, because when this came in, I was just like, oh my God, like I can top off other vanilla fragrances that I'm wearing on my tray with this. So I cheated on it, but I didn't regret it. You know, like these trays are very much good to me for guidance and for learning more about the fragrances that I have, but they are no means for me just restricting me from wearing other fragrances. Those are my fragrance tray rules. Do you have fragrance tray rules? Let me know what they are in the comment section down below. That is it from me. I hope that you enjoyed this video. Please remember to like, share, and subscribe to my channel if you haven't subscribed as yet and you enjoy content like this. Don't forget to hit on the notification bell so that you're notified each and every time I drop a video on my channel. And don't forget to click on the thumbs up button as well if you like this video. It really goes a long way to helping my channel to grow. And I hope to see you in my next video soon. Bye.